Well, hello everybody, it's Bug Eater 64, and we're getting ready to do a flight here in the Twin Otter. And we're going to be going about about 408 miles, and we are flying from where we're at right now, North Island Naval Air Station, San Diego, California, and we're going to be flying to Travis Air Force Base, the Aero Club there in Fairfield, California. This is a cargo-only flight on FSEconomy, and we're going to be flying this little lady right here, twin turboprop, Twin Otter. And with that, we'll get this thing going. Again, trying to make a little scratch for the old virtual airline. So, we'll see you in the inside. So, let's go ahead and get inside our Twin Otter here and get things going. Get the door closed. And then we'll go to the aft section and close the passenger door. Now we can get things started here. Set our altimeter. And that looks about right. Yeah, presently we're sitting at down in San Diego at the Naval Air Station. And we'll get things going and get some power, get the battery on. Turn on the igniters. And throttles are looking good. Set the right engine mixture to full. Props to the first notch. And turn on a fuel pump. Switch it on. Let's get this thing started. Right engine, spooling up. Good engine start. And this doesn't really have a beacon per se, so we'll just put on some navigational lights and so on so people can see what we're doing down here. Okay. Go ahead and start it up. We'll turn on the fuel pump in just a second. Get it all right. Let's introduce some fuel. So, two good engine starts. And let's get some. It's a little cloudy outside, so we're gonna. Yeah, we don't need that light. Okay. Get the generators on. Sometimes very argumentative. There we go. So, both generators on. Engines are running, everything's looking just the way it should. It's all copacetic. Now let's get some avionics on. Radio pack stack. Set our altitude, which we're looking at about 8,000 if we go up that high, which I probably should. Turn the Garmin on, but we're going to be using the GTN 750. Down here to the end of the runway, get ready for takeoff. I think X-Plane needs to do a little update, because I don't think you'd see any F-4 Phantoms at the Naval Air Station, North Island, at this day and age. Would be a rare thing. Let's just go ahead and move out here. Flaps are set for takeoff. The DHC6-300 twin turboprop, not a fast airplane by any means. Great bush plane. So, let's give her some power. Let's try to get the props synced up here. Airspeed's definitely alive. V1 and rotate. Gradual climb here. We'll get on our heading. Whoopsie. That's not the way you do it. I was wondering why I was not gaining speed quicker. Let's get the RPMs up where they belong. See if we can get this to work. Ooh, looks like it wants to dive me into the ground. Not a good thing. Work through it. Which we are going to do. So, let's get her done. See you on the other side. Alrighty then, got it all figured out. Had some issues getting the autopilot to work properly. It's been a long time since I flew this, and that was a big part of the problem. But for now, I figure we'll just take our time. We're cruising about 3,500 feet. We're not too far below the cloud cover, and I wanted to enjoy taking a look at some of the orthos of the Southern California area. So we'll do a little of that. Check our clock. All good. Flying through some clouds. There's not a lot to see anyway. Feet, airspeed about 155 knots. Ground speed's about 161, and 300 plus miles to go. I wanted to look at the orthos, but right now there's not much of anything to look at. But hopefully we'll break out of it here. We're should be approaching Los Alamitos area. See if we can see the Los Alamitos airport. That's the Los Angeles River, I think. Maybe too far south for that, but it's one of the big channels. There's Los Alamitos. Yeah, that should be the Los Angeles River Basin. A good portion of it through this Southern California, it's all concrete. It's part of the flood control system. I'm cracking, I can't remember the name of that airport. Well, we're still south of LAX. Very, very cloudy day. Ortho for XP, those orthos definitely just make everything look so much better. Moving just fine so far. Just droning along. Some hesitation there with evidently frame rate issues. That hasn't happened for a while. That's something that, you know, kind of comes and goes. For the most part, X-Plane 11 runs extremely smooth on my machine. Still running an i7 CPU, but I am running a 2080 Ti. GPU, which just makes everything look gorgeous. And the city, it's a gray day. And that white spot over there, that's LAX. Mistaken. I think that's Bob Hope Airport over there to the right. So while everything is cruising along, autopilot, everything is nominal, just like it's supposed to. You'll forgive me if I leave it on autopilot and step away for a couple minutes and grab some of my co-pilot's good cooking. So we'll see you when I get back. And I'm back. And this is what I found. Not good. What can I say? I'm sad. This is how not to fly at low altitude, even though you think you've got enough altitude to get over the hills, and then walk away from the simulation to get some food. That's what happened. There I was, enjoying my homemade chili dogs. And I walked back in, sat down in front of the simulation with that sign, "You crashed! You're a dirtbag! You're evil!" So, it's not a complete loss. The airplane is toast, but when it came to the FSEconomy flight, was able to cancel it, so no problems there, you know. And we'll just do a flight later on. Terrible, terrible, terrible. But anyway, it makes for an interesting video. And hope you enjoyed it. Hope you were as surprised as I was about the crash. And we'll see y'all next time. So this is Bug Eater 64 saying, until then, hey everybody, don't do as I do, do as I say. Safe flying.